In this video, I'm going to show you how to upload and share files such as your course syllabi and course packets. Before we get there, I want to introduce a file naming convention. Of course, this convention would or may change as your department will come up with a different naming convention. But for now, this is an example. So I would say name the file with APPRL followed by a blank space, followed by three-digit course ID, and followed by a blank space and course packet. If it's course packet, otherwise it's a syllabus, or it could be kind of any kind of a common word or words to describe the content, and perhaps the quarter. So that's 2016 fall quarter. So this is a naming convention. Of course, as I mentioned, it may change. The purpose of this naming convention will be just easier file management as you will accumulate more files. Anyway, so let's start. To upload and share your files, first you're going to go to the files index, and then to upload your file, and then you are going to share the file on the modules page. So okay, so go to files. In the files index, you have basically two panes. One is over here on the left side and on the right side here. So if you're familiar with Windows Explorer or file management system, you'll see you have like some kind of a tree branch system or structure. So School of Apparel Design and Development, that's the root, that's the top or the bottom, depending on how you looking at it. That's the root of your file management structure. Under that, you have course packets and syllabi, which is further divided into courses. So Apparel 096, 098, and this will be organized in this that way. If your course is not listed here, you can add a new folder. So adding new folder button is over here. But before you add anything, make sure that you are in the right place. So I'm going to add a new folder within course packets and then syllabi. So I need to go there. And another way to verify if you are at the right place is looking at this breadcrumb navigation. So it says you're inside of course packets and syllabi folder, which is this one. Okay, so once that is selected, and I'm going to click on folder, and I'm going to name APPRL 1 space 097, and press enter key. So because I'm following the naming convention, this folder gets entered in the right place in terms of the sequence of the files. All right, so that's how you do it. And also, since we are here, you'll see these are the content of whatever that is selected on the left pane. So if I click on media files, I will see the content of that. And as I click on any of these subfolders, I will see the content. So for example, media files, under there is an images folder, and inside the images folder, I have these picture files. That's how it is organized. So let me upload reading packet or course packet for 101. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that folder, and currently it is empty, and I'm going to click on the upload button, and then locate the file. And let's see here, that's the file. So just so you can see, the I'm following the naming convention, appll one space 101 space course packet space F18. So that's file 2018, that's PDF. So go ahead and click on open. All right, so it is uploaded. So a couple of things, as you kind of work with the Canvas files, you'll notice this kind of green check button. So that basically means it is published, meaning that it is available, but it's not all the way available yet, because you will be putting this file, if you want to share this file, you'll be putting this file on the modules page over here. And also, you'll notice that as you hover over any part of the file on that line, you'll also see this gear icon. So that's an invitation to click, and you'll see options such as renaming, moving, deleting, and so on. Okay, so now I have this file in my Canvas, or your Canvas shell, and I'm going to put that on the modules page so that it is easily accessible. So as an instructor, by the way, in this shell, you can go directly to the files, and then you can go to course packets and syllabi, and then apparel design 111, not 111, 101, and you can download it. You can hover over, you can click on download. So that's perfectly fine way to get the files for yourself. But to make it easier for everybody, including yourself, I will recommend you putting this new file on the modules page. So let me just go back home. I'll show you the next step. So I uploaded the file already in the files area. Next step is the modules. So modules is like a storefront where the customers, in this case your colleagues, will come in and just shop. Instead of opening up your storage in the back room, you don't send the customers in the back room. You have them shop in the storefront, and then you know they will just order the designer clothes, and store clerk will get the item to the customers. So this is where this is how it should work or could work. And so this is the, again, the modules is where you have the customers come in and pick and choose. So again, you are putting this item to be available. To do so, you'll go to the modules and then find this plus sign under course packets and syllabi. So click on plus sign. So you are adding something. And what are you adding? In this case, you are not adding assignments. So I click on it, and I'm adding a file. And what file? Well, you have all these files in your Canvas shell. In my case here, I have this file on the course files, course packets and syllabi, appll 101. Remember that folder structure? And I click on the file name and then click on add item. And you'll see nothing change. And in fact, it's because it's added. Whenever you add a new item within this module group, it's get added at the bottom. So over here. Okay, so I need to move this up. So to move it, I've looked for this this 8 dots area. So I hover over, then I have this move icon pointer, and I click on it, and I drag it. I'm holding down and I'm dragging up, and then when I go between 101 and 111, I let go of the button, and it gets tugged in. So you can, you know, if you drop it in a kind of quote unquote wrong place, it's not an issue. You just move it to the right place. Click, hold down, and drag and drop. And if you want to, you can do the indentation, increase indent, or decrease indent. It's just for decoration, you know, purposes. Nothing more than that. So once that is done, and then your colleagues will come in and they will click on this, and they can do the preview. And so the preview is working, and then they can click on this link, and then it'll download. And that's how you will share the files.